Julie!
What?
My finger!
It's only a band, John. Sarah said she once put cow dung on her band and her band healed. So she says cow dung heals burns.
Really?
Look, there's some cow dung.
Not a typical lesson you would expect in a classroom.
How did you know that this one is Mr. Mark? Are they labeled at Mr. Mark?
It is hoped that these cartoons will help them question common health myths.
Why? Yes.
They are designed to help the students identify what is a false claim and question the information they are given.
So that claim is
unreliable.
It is what?
They're part of a group of 10,000 students in different countries going through lessons developed by an organization called Informed Health Choices.
Before, I used to believe the people, what they say. Now, I don't.
I've learned that experts can be right or wrong.
These lessons will help us to make good choices about treatments in the future.
More than half the population in Uganda is below the age of 15. So by giving lessons like this on how to spot fake information, you can help change the thinking of a large number of people in the country. And it's important that this way of thinking is taught early while children are still in school. An estimated 68% of children drop out of school in Uganda before they make it to high school. That's just behind Chad, which has the highest dropout rate across Africa. Getting children to question things early will not only help them now, but in the future as well. The teachers are seeing a difference after a few lessons, and the parents at home too.
The parent asked a child to eat many carrots because the child had a problem with his eyes. Then now the child asked the parent, what is the basis for that claim? So that meant that the children are taking on the lesson and they are impacting on them.
With the program now expanded to Kenya and Rwanda and also translated into several languages, its success and growth is climbing to greater heights.